Hello everybody, this is Yogesh Singh from IIC Bangalore. So in this video, we are going to develop problem solving technique for diode with capacitor topic. So if you are not comfortable in this topic, then this video is going to be for you. I have divided the problem of this topic into three categories. And whenever you see any problem on this topic, that will definitely fall any of those three categories, which will let you solve the problem easily and faster. So watch the video till the end. We will be developing a thought process. What should be exactly you think when you see any problem on this topic? Okay, so let us start with this. So whenever you see any topic, when diode is connected with capacitor in a single circuit, diode with capacitor, so that problem can be of either a clamper, or it can be a problem of peak detector. If these two circuit are not there, then it will be any general circuit. Okay, so we will be talking about how we will be dealing with this general circuit. So third category is a general circuit. Okay, so clamper, again we have two types. It can be a negative clamper or it is a positive clamper. Okay, and peak detector, again it is can be a negative peak detector or it can be a positive peak detector. Okay, so let us see how a negative peak, negative clamper look like. So a negative clamper is So negative clamper is, we have a capacitor and then diode is connected like this. Okay, and the input AC signal is there, and from here we will be taking output. Okay, so this is a negative peak, negative clamper, and then if diode polarity is reversed like this, and the similar capacitor and input AC supply is connected, AC input voltage is connected, then it is going to be a, this is C, this is D, this is going to be a positive clamper, right? Similarly, a negative positive peak detector, if we see a positive peak detector is, we have a connected capacitor with this polarity, and then capacitor is connected. One diode and capacitor is connected like this. We are taking output from here and then input we are applying here. So the output will be detecting the peaks of input, right? Or positive peaks of input, because it is a positive peak detector. And similarly, a negative peak detector, if we reverse the polarity of diode like this, and input is connected here and capacitor is connected like this, so output we will take from a capacitor, and what output will be, it will be detecting the negative peak of input. Okay, so this is a negative peak detector. So let us start with the clamper. First we will be talking about the operation of this basic circuitry, right? How the clamper are working, and then we will be jumping to the problems. Okay, so let us see a negative clamper first. So this is a circuit of, this is a capacitor, this is diode, so this is a VI, input sinusoidal signal. Okay, so this is a capacitor, this is a negative clamper. Okay, now let us say input, okay, we will be talking input and capacitor voltage and output voltage. Okay, so let us say the input is sinusoidal, VI equals to, and the maximum peak is VM, and this VI we have is VI equals to VM sin omega t, and this is a minus VM. Okay, so this x is t, and it is a t by 4, it is going to be t, this is a 3t by 4, and this is t. Okay, let us extend this vertical axis, and this is a 3t by 4, and this is t. Okay, so in the clamper circuit, the key point you should note down is, we have to identify the capacitor up to what value of input this capacitor is charging. In all the questions of this clamper circuit, this is going to be key point, and this is going to be very important. In all the questions, what we have to find out is up to what value of input this capacitor is charging. Because the clamper means we want to clamp the input, right? Clamping means shifting like this. If the input is like this and we want to shift it or clamp it like upward or downward, then for this, what we need is, we need an DC signal, right? We will be adding DC signal, then only it will be clamping, right? And DC signal, where we will get from? We will be getting from the charged or the voltage which this capacitor is stored. Once this capacitor is stored, we will not want this capacitor to discharge, because we want the DC signal stored by this capacitor, right? So we will be calculating up to what value of input this capacitor has stored, right? So let's talk about this. And VI, we have taken VM sin omega t, and if we apply a KCL here like this, So Vi will be Vc plus V output. This is a V output, or V output we have is equal to Vd. Okay. So Vc will be Vi minus V output. Okay. Now let us analyze it one by one. So in 0 to Ty4, when T we have 0 to Ty4, what will happen is positive clock cycle is coming. Okay. Capacitor initially we have discharge, and diode, let us say it is having a RF, that is a forward resistance is almost equal to 0. So that if tau charging time taken by this capacitor to charge equals to RF into C is almost equal to 0. So that this capacitor will immediately charge. Okay. And 0 to Ty4 we are analyzing this, and in the 0 to Ty4 we are having a VM. This is a VM signal, maximum peak of input, right? When maximum peak of input will be coming, this capacitor will be charging, right? Now what will be the resistance? This is the RF, RF into C. So RF into C is almost equal to 0. It means that the charging time for this capacitor will be negligible, right? Or it will be immediately charging. Okay, so it is immediately charging. So capacitor, this is Vc, and this is going to be V output. So if I draw the waveform for the capacitor, it will be immediately charging from 0 to Ty4. Up to what value it will charge? So Vc equals to Vi minus V naught. So Vi is Vm sine omega t. And what will be V naught? V naught means this voltage across this diode. Okay, so when positive peak is coming, this diode will be forward bias, because initially we are assuming this capacitor is discharged, so no voltage there. So Vm is coming, Vm, 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 and the positive terminal of diode will be Vm, and negative terminal is zero, right? So it will be forward bias, and we have assumed RF is almost equal to zero, then it will be replaced by short circuit. So if it is short circuit, then V output will be zero. So V output in 0 to Ty4 we got 0, and Vc we got charging from 0 to Vm. Okay, so this is a Vm. Now next, when we go at T equals to, let us say T by 4 plus. Okay, for simplicity let us say Vm equals to 10 volt. Okay, this is a 10, this was a 10, and at T by 4 plus, at this point it will be less than 10. Let us say it is a 9.9. okay, now Vi, I have now 9.9. if I put in this equation, what will happen is Vc equals to, or this is a Vd, right? We need a Vd now. So Vd will be Vi minus Vc. Okay, and Vi has reduced from 10 to 9.9, since we are analyzing it at Ty4 plus point. Okay, so 9.9 minus Vc we have is 10. Okay, so this is going to be minus 0.1. so voltage across diode we got at Ty4 plus is minus 0.1. so if it is minus 0.1, then it is negative, right? If it is negative, then the diode will be reverse bias and diode will be open. So this path will be open and capacitor will not have, okay, I will draw it. So this circuit will look like this. This diode is open and this is Vi, right? This capacitor is charged up to plus Vm, right? And this Vm or this capacitor is not having any path to discharge, so it will remain Vm, or it will hold this Vm, right? Now what about V output? See, V output is, if you apply again case KVL, or we put here, then what we will get is a Vc equals to Vi minus V output, or V output we have is a Vi minus Vc, right? And Vi we have is a Vi equals to Vm sin omega t, Vm sin omega t minus Vc is Vm, because the capacitor was charged up to Vm value. Okay, so V output is going to be this. Now at t equals to capital T, if we put, then Vi is 0, right? So this is Vi. So V output what we will get is 0 minus Vm, that is minus Vm. So at t we will get minus Vm. So let us say this is a minus Vm line, this is minus 2 Vm line. So this is minus Vm, this is going to be minus 2 Vm. Okay, now at t what we got is a Vm, or it is minus Vm. Okay, now at 3t by 4 Vi will be, this is Vi, what Vi will be? Minus Vm sin omega t. Okay, so at t equals to 3t by 4, Vi what we will have? Vi is going to be minus Vm sin omega t. Okay, now Vi is minus Vm sin omega t and Vc is minus Vm. So it is going to be, V output is going to be now minus of Vm sin of omega t and minus Vm, right? Now maximum value of this will be minus Vm, then output maximum value will be minus Vm minus Vm, it is going to be minus 2 Vm. At what point? At 3t by 4. So here it is going to be minus Vm. So similarly, what we will be getting is like this, this minus 2vm and will going to be 0. Like this waveform we will get. So this was the transient, and at steady state what we got is at steady state the minimum value, or in negative direction the maximum value, we got minus 2vm and minimum is 0, right? So it will be touching this, so minimum will be 0. So in negative peak detector, at steady state negative peak detector, what we got is V output equals to vi minus vm. Okay, so this is the thing you should know, okay, to solve the problems. So this is for a negative peak detector. Similarly for positive, not detector, it is a clamper. Okay, so for negative clamper we got V output is equal to vi minus vm, and for positive clamper V output is going to be vi plus vm. Similarly, similar operation we will be doing, and we will be getting V output is equal to vi plus vm. So this is a positive and negative clamper. And for peak detector, you know, when input, how it will working is, when let us say input is like this, okay, and if this input is given to the positive peak detector, now as output what you will be getting is, you will be detecting the positive peaks. So like this positive peak you have detected, and then you will hold it, and then again positive peak, hold it, again positive peak, hold it, positive peak. So like this, so you will keep on detecting positive peak. So this is a positive peak detector. Okay, now this is about how this basic procedure is, and we will go to the problems. Okay, so let us see this is the problem. Okay, before this we should know for the problem of this diode with capacitor circuit, we should know this basic procedure. And if it is a positive clamper, then you should know V output is going to be Vi plus Vm. If it is negative clamper, then you should know V output is going to be Vi minus Vm. Or if it is a positive or negative peak detector, then you should know how it is detecting. So if it is positive peak detector, then it will be detecting the positive peak. If it is input, if it is input like this, this black one was input, and the output is going to be red one. That is a detection of positive peak of input, right? And if it is a negative peak detector, then for negative peak, it will be detecting the negative peaks. So this is the basic, you know, operation of this clamper and detector, or four type circuits. Now we will go with the solution and developing our thought process, how we should think when we are seeing new problem. Okay, so let us see. Okay, so this is the problem, and now by looking this problem, what you should think is, first you should check whether out of these four circuits, positive clamper, negative clamper, negative peak detector, positive peak detector, if any of these four standard circuits are there or not. So whenever you see problem, you should first identify whether these circuits are there or not. Okay, so this is the first step you are going to do. Okay, so the first step is you have to identify. Now if you check it, whether it is what is this is the positive clamper, right? So positive clamper we had was one capacitor, and then diode were connected with this polarity, right? So this is the similar to a positive peak positive clamper, right? Now this is positive clamper. Now let us see how we will be solving it. Okay, so yeah, we have identified that this is a positive peak detector. Okay, one step is done. Now next what we have to do is, I have told you, if it is a positive peak, positive clamper, not detector, if it is a positive clamper, then V output is going to be Vi plus Vm. Okay, because this Vm is the charged capacitor voltage. Okay, the voltage up to which this capacitor is charged. And for negative clamper you have to apply is V output equals to Vi minus Vm. This we have seen, this how it is coming. Okay, now if we give Vi equals to 20 sin omega t, okay, and in this question what we are asked is we have to find out the output waveform. So input waveform, if we give Vi equals to, this is 20 and this is minus 20. Okay, if we are giving this input waveform, and we are asked what should be the output waveform, so we know this is going to be V output equals to Vi plus Vm. So in all the circuit what you have to do is, you have to make this diode on and charge the capacitor, because in clamper you want this capacitor to charge, and after or once it is charged, you want never it to be discharged. Okay, because you want to clamp, right? And you need a DC voltage, so you need DC voltage from this capacitor. So this capacitor once charged will not discharge, and then it will be retaining this positive DC voltage, right? So that it will help to clamp, right? Now what we want is, we want this capacitor to charge. Now how it will charge? It will be charging when this diode will be on, right? So our thought process is, we have to always make this diode on and charge the capacitor. So we will be seeing the circuit in this way, such that this diode is on and the capacitor is charging. Now capacitor will be charging plus minus like this, okay? Now we will be applying Vi equals to V naught plus Vc, okay? And when this diode will be on, this will be shorted, right? So V output will be zero. So Vi equals to Vc, it means that Vc equals to Vi. So capacitor will be charging up to maximum value of this input. From here also we have verified this, that V of Vc is going to be 20 volt, because Vi is having a peak value is 20, okay? So Vc, that is a charge value, or the capacitor will be charged up to 20 volt, okay? Now V output, we have to find out V output equals to, V output is going to be now Vi plus Vm, and Vm we have find out 20, so it is going to be 20. So what V output is, we have to shift 20 upward, shift Vi by 20 volt upward, right? So if we shift this, what output we will get is, this is a V output, and then what V output will be, it will be shifted upward 20 volt. So this is 0, this will reach to 20, let us say here it is 20, here it is a 40. Okay, so like this, so we will be getting, okay, so 40 to 20, no, it is not correct. The thing which is at minus 20 will reach to this thing minus 20 will reach to 0, and the thing which is 0, it will be reached to 20, so like this, so we will be getting, like this. So this is 20, this is 40, and this is 0. So this is the answer for the first one, if the input waveform is 20 sin omega t. Now let us see, what if Vi equals to 10 sin omega t minus 10 sin omega t minus 10, okay? When Vi, this is the second one, okay? When Vi is 10 of sin omega t minus 10, right? Now in this case, what will happen is, again, we have to check up to what value this capacitor will charge, okay? So this is a 10 sin omega t, and this can be minus 10 or 10, okay? So we have to check minus 10 minus 10 minus 20, or 10 minus 10 0. So extreme value this input is going to be going to have is minus 20 or 0, okay? And we have to charge this capacitor, okay? So capacitor will be charging the extreme positive value of extreme value of this input, right? That is going to be 20, right? So V output equals to going to be Vi plus Vm. And in this case, Vm is going to be what? Vm is going to be 20, right? Because capacitor has to charge to maximum value of this, right? And this maximum value is going to be minus 20. So if it is minus 20, then we are charging it this way, okay? So it is going to be Vi plus Vm, and then Vi is 10 sin omega t minus 10, and Vm is Vi plus, this is going to be 20, okay? So what it will be, 10 sin omega t plus 10, okay? So this is a 10 sin omega t, and we will be shifting it by 10. This is a 10, this is a minus 10, right? So we will be shifting it, and what we will get is a V output equals to, this will be the waveform of V output. The thing which is at minus 10 will reach at 0 here, and the thing which is at 0 will reach at 10. So this, like this, we will be getting, this is going to be 10, this is going to be 20, and this is going to be 0. So this is for second question, and for the third question, again, this Vi, we are having a 10 and minus 10. So again, we have to charge the capacitor. A capacitor will be charged up to maximum value of Vi. So maximum value of Vi, it means Vm or Vc is going to be Vm equals to 10 volt. So in this case also, what V output we have to write, Vi plus Vm, because this is a positive clamper, right? So this will be shifted by Vm. Vm means 10 volt. So this output, what we will get is, this is the third one. So output will be shifted by 10 volt. So what we will getting is like this. So 0 to 20, and this is going to be 10. So this is the answer of the first question. So like this, we have to think. The key point is, we have to charge this capacitor by the maximum value of this Vi, okay? And we do not have to think like if Vi is having maximum value 0 or 20 is minimum. No, we have to take the extreme value, positive or extreme value, right? If it is 20, then 20. If it is by minus 40, then we would have taken minus 40, right? Let us do our next question. So this is a PYQ. And if we see again in the first question what our thought process was, we have to check whether this our input or this our question is matching with the four standard circuit, two clamper or two peak detector. If these that four circuits are not there, then we have to go by third category, that is general method, right? So general method is positive clock cycle, what is happening in negative clock cycle, what is happening, and according to the question we have to solve. Okay, so in the second question is like this only. This circuit is not matching, neither it is a positive clamper nor negative clamper, neither it is a positive peak detector nor a negative peak detector. Okay, so we have to solve this by general method, right? So general method is going to be what is going to happen positive clock cycle, what is going to happen negative clock cycle. Okay, so if nothing is mentioned here, let us assume this is a positive. Okay, so let us say this is a positive and this is a negative. Okay, we can assume this positive, this negative also, it won't matter. Now VI is also not given. Now let us assume VI is going to be, since it is giving sinusoidal, so assume VI equals to Vm sine of omega t. Okay, now let us say this input we have, this is Vm and this is going to be minus Vm. Okay, so when positive clock cycle, that is T by 2 and this is T. Okay, now when positive clock cycle is coming, what will happen is, see, this is a V plus Vm, this is going to be plus Vm, positive clock cycle, this is going to be plus Vm, and initially nothing is given, then initially we will assume this capacitor are discharged, or this is uncharged capacitor, right? So this will be sorted and this is going to be zero. So plus Vm is connected at cathode terminal of diode and the zero is at anode terminal. So this diode will be what? This diode will be reverse bias. Okay, similarly in this case, this is a zero and this is a Vm. So Vm is connected to positive terminal of diode and the zero is negative. So this diode will be on. Okay, so now let us at positive clock cycle. So let us make this circuit. What we will get is this diode will be off. Okay, this and this, this is plus, this is minus, this is V output and this is a capacitor C and this is Vi. Okay, like this we will have. Okay, this is connected like this and then this diode is going to be sorted. So this diode will be sorted and one capacitor is connected. Okay, so like this. So Vi is equal to Vm sine omega t. Vm sine omega t. Okay, so Vm will be coming here, Vm will be coming here. So this capacitor will be charging. Let us call it, this is a C1, let us call it C2. Okay, so this capacitor C2 will be charging up to plus Vm. Okay, so Vc2. From this Vc2 what we got is a Vm. Okay, so this is about positive clock cycle. Now let us see negative clock cycle. What will happen in negative clock cycle is, again this is a negative clock cycle, then this is going to be minus Vm, right? This is going to be minus Vm and this is a discharge capacitor or uncharged capacitor, then this is going to be zero. So minus Vm is connected at the cathode terminal and zero at anode terminal. So this diode will be on. Okay, so let's make it this diode is sorted, this is on, this is capacitor C1. Okay, and this is plus minus V output. Okay, and again this is connected anode terminal, since this diode, this capacitor is charged to plus Vm, right? So this is now plus Vm and this is coming minus Vm. So positive terminal of this or anode is connected to negative terminal, then this diode will be off. Okay, so let us make it this diode is going to be off, it is going to be open. Okay, and this capacitor C2 is already charged to Vm. Okay, now what will happen is the current will not go in this, but current will go like this. Okay, so how current will flow is from Vi, current will flow like this and it will be charging the capacitor C1. Since no resistor is connected, then immediately this capacitor will be charged. So again from here Vc1 what we will get is minus Vm. Okay, because in this case we are analyzing negative clock and Vi is going to be then minus Vm sin omega t. Okay, so Vc1 we got minus Vm and then Vc2 we got plus Vm. Okay, so V output is Vc2 minus Vc1, that is Vm minus minus Vm. Okay, so this is going to be a 2 Vm. So input was Vm, maximum peak was Vm and then output we are getting maximum peak is 2 Vm. Then it is going to be a voltage doubled up because input is doubled. Okay, so this is how you should think when you have a problem when a standard circuit are not connected in the circuit. Okay, now let us move to the next question. So this is the circuit. Now, by looking at the circuit, again you have to think whether this circuit is related to the standard four circuit, two circuit of a clamper and two circuit of a peak detector, whether these circuits are connect related to that those circuit or not. Now if you observe, one capacitor is connected and then one diode is connected, then this part is going to be a negative clamper, right? And this part is going to be a negative peak detector. Okay, now how you have to solve this circuit then? Okay, first step is done. You have identified and input, you have a cos omega t. So again, this is a capacitor, this is a voltage, this is a diode, and then again this is a negative clamper. Okay, so in negative clamper, what you know is V output equals to Vi minus Vm. Okay, where Vm is what? Maximum peak value of this cos t. Okay, so Vi we have is cos omega t, and Vm we have the maximum peak of this, it is 1, so it is going to be minus 1. So V output 1, let's call it VO1, and VO1 we are given is Vt. So Vt, what we got is cos of omega t minus 1. Okay, so what we are asked in the question is Vt across D1. So across this diode, Vt will be cos omega t minus 1. So this is how you can solve easily problem if you know how to proceed with the problems. Okay, so next question. Okay, so this is the question, PYQ. In the circuit shown, assume that diodes D1 and D2 are ideal. In the steady state, we are given this D1 and D2 are ideal. It means that the voltage drop or the cutting voltage of these diodes is zero. And in the steady state condition, the average voltage VAB across the 0.5 microfarad. So across this capacitor, we have to find out voltage. Okay. Now, if you observe this, this is a VI equals to 50 sine omega t. And this is one capacitor, 1 micro, and again this is diode, this is going to be D1, it is connected to terminal B. Again you have a diode D2, and this is connected to capacitor. Okay, that is a 0.5 micro, and this is connected like this, and this voltage we are calling is a VAB. Okay, now again you have to relate this circuit with your standard four circuits. Okay, now if you see this one capacitor, one diode, now this is going to be what? This is going to be positive clamper. Okay, so this half portion is going to be a positive clamper, this is going to be positive clamper, and this is going to what? This is going to be positive peak detector, right? Positive peak detector. Okay, so whatever, let us call it VO1, so whatever waveform VO1 will be having, this circuit will be detecting the positive peak of this VO1, right? Now we know this is a positive clamper, and positive clamper we should write V output equals to VI plus VM. Okay, where VM is the voltage of this VI or peak voltage of this VI, right? So VI we have is 50 sine of omega t, and Vm is going to be peak value of this, that is 50. So this is what VO1 we got, right? And we have to find out the peak or the positive peak value. Okay, if we draw this, this is going to be, okay, this is going to be 50, this is going to be minus 50. Okay, and this is a VI. Okay, if we find out the VO1, if we draw VO1, that is going to be a 50. If we shift it, then what we'll get is, we'll get like this. This is going to be 100, and this is going to be 50, and this is going to be 0. Okay, so its peak value, what its peak value we have is 100. Okay, so what this V output, okay, the voltage across this capacitor, so V output, what we will get is 100. Now this V output is nothing but VAB. Okay, so VAB, what we will get is 100. So this is how we should proceed with the questions. Okay. Now let us move to the next question. So this is the question, what we are asked in this question is, let us see. In the figure, D1 is real silicon PN junction diode with drop voltage of 0.7. so this is the diode, and the, okay, let's zoom it. Yeah, so this is the diode. So V gamma 1. Okay, so for diode voltage D1, the cut-in voltage is given 0.7 volt under forward bias condition, and the D2 is a zener diode with the breakdown voltage of minus 6.8. Okay, so VZ mod is going to be 6.8 volt. Okay, so when it is breaking down, then we will be replacing it by 6.8 volt battery. Okay. Now the input VNT is a periodic signal, periodic square wave of period T, whose one time with one period is shown in the figure. Okay, so this is the input we are given, and what we are asked is, okay, so we are asked the V output. Now let's find out. It's not mentioned in the question, but the question is what is the V output or waveform of V output. Okay, so again we have to see a capacitor is connected and a diode is connected. Do you think what kind of circuit it is? We have seen a four kind. So one capacitor and then diode, or we can see it is a negative clamper, right? But to know this or to solve this, only one diode are supposed to be connected there, but two diodes are connected. Okay, then we can solve it, but we will go with the basic method. If four those circuits are not there, then go with the basic method. Okay, basic method is what's going to happen in positive clock cycle and what will happen in negative clock cycle. Okay, now by going the basic, then the positive clock cycle, or by going general method, is positive clock cycle, what will happen is V in we are given a 14 volt. Okay, now when V in is 14, and assume that the capacitor is initially uncharged, right? So this is going to be 14. So if we apply 14 here, you will get 14 here, right? Now if you see, this is going to be a plus minus 0.7, and this is going to be plus minus 6.8. okay, so overall what is going to be a 6.8 plus 0.7, so what is going to be 715, and then 7.5 volt. Okay, so if here I am getting greater than 7.5, then this will be replaced by 7.5. okay, otherwise it will be open. Okay, now 14 I am getting, and obviously it is greater than 7.5, then what will happen is in positive clock cycle V equals to 14 volt. So what will happen is this capacitor will be charging to positive peak of this input, right? So it will be charged to plus minus. Okay, let us see, this is replaced by 7.5, and here we are applying 14. This is happening, and this is a VC. Okay, and one resistor is also connected. Yeah, this is a 10 ohm is connected. Okay, now this is 14 here, I am getting 14 here, and here is 7.5. now up to what by what value this capacitor is charged, then VC equals to 14 minus 7.5. so this is going to be VM. okay, so maximum value by which this capacitor will be charged is the VM equals to, which is going to be 7.5 volt. so this is the voltage by which the capacitor will be charging. Okay, and the output in this case what we will get is 7.5. so V output is 7.5 volt. so in positive clock cycle we have find out V output. Now let us go to a negative clock cycle. So in negative clock cycle, VI what we are applying, minus 14 volt. And let us see, this is charged, this is already charged to 6.5 volt. this is a capacitor charged to 6.5 volt, and here what we are applying is like this, it is what it is, 14 volt. Okay, so this is a 14 volt. Now what will happen about this, will we get a 7.5 volt or not? So this is a minus 14 here, what you will get, it is going to be 6.5 and plus 14, that too negative. Okay, so it is going to be a minus 20.5 volt. So here you will be getting is a minus 20.5, but to make it function, or this zener diode to be in breakdown, it and this diode to be on, what you need is plus 7.5, but you got minus 20.5, so this is going to be open. Okay, now in this case what the output will be if you apply a KVL here, so what you will get is a V output equals to minus 6.5 minus 14. So V output in this case what you are going to get is a minus 20.5 volt. okay, so you have considered both positive and negative, and if you draw the output waveform, so in positive clock cycle what you got is 7.5, and in negative clock cycle what you got is minus 20.5. so this is the output waveform for this question.